Hello and welcome to the video tutorials of Advanced Java Programming. This is Rajul Suthar, Assistant Professor of Sri Swaminarayan Institute of Technology, Bard Gandhinagar, in Computer Department. Previously, we have discussed JDBC driver type 1 and type 2. In this video lecture, we will discuss the type 3 driver. So, it is the all Java or NET protocol driver. We can say that Java protocol driver. In this type 3 driver, we will discuss with figure. So, here the some description related to the type 3. It is a pure Java driver or dependent on middleware server. We require one middleware server or component server. It can interface to multiple database, not vendor specific. Previous driver like type 2 driver is vendor specific, and type 1 driver that cover the JDBC, ODBC bridge. So type 3 driver not cover any vendor, and it follow the three tier communication approach. We already covered in client server communication. So this is a three-tier communication approach is used in type 3. JDBC client use standard network socket to communicate with a middleware application server. Once socket information is then translated by middleware application server into the call format required by the DBMS. This kind of driver is extremely flexible since it is required no code installation on the client, and a single driver can actually provide the access to multiple database. So this is the figure. Here local computer Java application is used. So here application code is in the format of Java. It covers the extension .java. We use the type 3 JDBC NET pure Java driver or NET protocol driver. Database server you can use MySQL or MS Access. One middleware server is used. So middleware server is nothing but it covers the all type of driver like JDBC driver type 1, 2 or 3. You can use any type of driver to communicate with database server. With the help of middleware server, the type 3 driver translate the JDBC call into database server. Database server independent and middleware server, it is a specific calls. It use the specific calls. So type 3 driver, it's NET common protocol. We can say that it use the NET common protocol. Type 3 driver translate the JDBC call from Java application to middleware server. So communication path is JDBC call. Here the JDBC call is performed from Java application to middleware server. So this is the middleware server. After all, the driver communication with middleware component or server, and this middleware server convert this call into database specific calls. So this call is converted into database specific calls. To connect with database server. So what is the disadvantage and disadvantage of this type of a driver? Here we require the vendor specific protocol as well as network communication. First advantage, so we all familiar, there is no need of any vendor driver, vendor database library to present on client machine because it is a server based driver. So since the communication between client and middleware server is database independent, we can say that it is database independent. There is no need of database vendor library on client. Second, this driver is fully written in Java, hence portable. Only a single driver can handle the database. It provide the middleware support. we required only single driver. We in the middleware we covered number of type driver, but at a time only single type driver is used. We can switch from one database to other without changing the client side driver classes. By just changing the configuration of middleware server. So it is suitable for web application. Again, we can say that the advantage is it is suitable for web application. Previous driver like type 1 driver and type 2 driver is not suitable for web application, or it is not a thread safe. Type 3 driver is very small and fast to load. It is faster, we can say that it is a faster, and this driver is very flexible to allow access multiple database using the single driver. In type 3 driver we use the IDS server or web logic remote method invocation driver, RMI driver is used. So this is the example of type 3 driver. And what is the disadvantage? In compare to the type 2 driver, type 3 driver are very slow due to the increased number of network call. In the compare of type 2, type 3 driver is slow, but in compare of type 1, type 3 driver is fast. We can say that it is small and fast. Fastly load, but in the comparison with the type 2 driver it is slow due to the increased number of network call. Number of call is increased, so the communication becomes slow. It required the database specific coding to be done in middleware, middle tier required database specific coding. Then the middleware layer added may result in additional latency, but is typically overcome by using the better middleware services. It required supporting for server application to install and monitor the connection. Again, disadvantage like the database come from backend server, hence it is make the traversal of record set a big time consuming. So it is required the maximum time to transmit the data from one side to another side. And last, let me discuss JDBC driver type 4. It is the database protocol, or we can say that native protocol. All the driver is covered in type 4. This type of a question asked in GTU 2013. So type 4 driver use the Java networking libraries to directly communicate with database server. Main advantage here covered we will discuss after completing the figure, but it is most suitable for web application. Don't need to install any special software on client or server. It is known as the direct to database pure Java driver. We can say that type 4 driver is a pure Java driver. Need to download a new driver for each of the database engine, example Oracle or MySQL. Type 4 driver, a pure Java based driver, communicate directly with vendors database through the socket communication. This kind of driver is extremely flexible. You don't need to install special software on the client or server. So this is the advantage. Such the driver are implemented by DBMS vendors. Here the figure of type 4 driver is so local computer where your program is stored, or it is the GUI client interface. One Java application code is written here. here simple your hello program or any program written in dot java. Then pure means 100% pure java driver is covered. So type 4 driver is native protocol or pure java. Then vendor specific protocol use network communication. So no any intermediate, it is directly communicated with database server. So type 4 driver use the Java networking libraries to directly communicate with the database server. You can say that this is the advantage. Completely implement in Java to achieve the platform independence. No native libraries are required to be installed on client machine. Any native library cannot be required. The driver don't translate the request into the intermediary format such as ODBC. It is secure to use since it is use the database server specific protocol. The client application connects directly to the database server and no translation of middleware layer are used, improving the performance. Java virtual machine manage all the aspect of the application to database connection. And main disadvantage here, with this type of a driver use the database specific protocol and it is a DBMS vendor independent. With this type of a driver is type 4 driver, the user need a different driver for each of the database. Here two types of driver covered, like thin driver and thick driver. So what do you mean by thin driver? One question asked in GTU exam, thin driver. So you can connect to database without the client installation on your machine. So last we have discussed type 4 driver is thin driver. We not required any software. We don't need to install special software on client or server machine. So this is the thin driver. And what do you mean by thick driver? Thick client would need the client installation. So type 1 and type 2 driver we already discussed. The JDBC ODBC bridge driver and native API partially Java driver. Type 1 and type 2 driver is thick driver. Let me discuss the comparison between JDBC driver. So this is the summary. We can say that type 1 driver, type 2 driver, type 3 and type 4. The name of the driver is, type 1 driver is JDBC ODBC bridge. Type 2 is native code driver, Java native API. Type 3 driver is Java protocol or middleware. And type 4 is database protocol. We can say that this is the portable. No, this is not a portable. Type 2 is not also portable. Type 3 is portable and type 4 is also portable. Is the type 1 driver is vendor specific? No, it is not a vendor specific. Type 2 is, yes, it is vendor specific. Type 3, no, it is not a vendor specific. But type 4 is also vendor specific. Type 1 is pure Java driver? No, we cannot say that type 1 is a pure Java driver. Type 2 is also not a pure Java, but type 3 and type 4 are pure Java driver. And working in type 1, so it use the JDBC ODBC call. We all familiar. If you not revise, so just check in figure of ODBC type 1 driver, JDBC ODBC bridge. So it cover the JDBC ODBC call as well as ODBC native call is used to communicate with server. Type 2 driver, the working of the type 2 driver is JDBC call and native specific call is used. In the type 3 driver, JDBC call, middleware specific, it use the middleware native call. While this is the JDBC call and DBMS specific calls, no any intermediate is used. So this one is a best. JDBC directly call with to the database specific calls. So one-to-one communication is possible by using this type 4 driver. Here database is used. So JDBC directly connected with database. No any vendor specific or type 4 driver use the Java networking library to directly communicate with database server. So this is the advantage of type 4 driver. And last one is multiple database. So yes, type 1 driver cover the multiple database, only ODBC supported database. Type 2 driver not cover the multiple database. Type 3, it cover the multiple database like DB driver should be installed, and type 4 not required the multiple database. Again, what is the example of type 1? So Microsoft Access is a example of type 1 driver. Type 2 driver that cover the Oracle OCI driver. Type 4, it is the IDA server, and type 3 cover the IDA server, and type 4 cover the MySQL. Execution become slower in type 1, faster in compare of type 1 in type 2. But type 3 also cover the slower compared to the type 2. While faster among type 4 communication is faster from all the other type of driver. We can say that type 1 and type 2 is a thick driver. These both are thick driver, but type 3 and type 4 are thin driver. So here one question in our mind, which driver should be used for proper communication? If you are accessing one type of database such as MySQL, Oracle, Sybase or IBM, so prefer the driver type is best. Type 4 driver is native protocol or Java, pure Java driver. If you are using the Java application, is accessing multiple types of database at the same time, type 3 driver is preferred. Type 3 is best. Type 2 driver are useful in situation where type 3 or type 4 driver is not available yet your database to connect. And type 1 driver is not considered as deployment level driver, and it is typically used for developing and testing purpose only. So we can say that type 4 driver is best for directly communication Java networking libraries with database server. JDBC with different RDBMS we will discuss in next video lecture. Thank you for attending this session.